Hello everybody, we are back, and welcome back to Let's Play 1.11. We are actually on a brand new snapshot just released today. We're on the 16W39B, as you can see there. And they've released a few bug fixes. One of the bugs which we actually ran into in the last episode has gladly been fixed, so you can actually now use coal in furnaces to smelt stuff, and you know, that's all resolved now, so we don't need to use up all our wooden planks when we're smelting. So here we are, we're down in a cave actually. I tried recording an episode last night, and I recorded it for about, it must have been about half an hour. I was down here mining, and the audio completely messed up on me when I came to view the recording afterwards. So that was not usable, and basically I'm here where I left off on that episode. This is the following day, and we're basically down in a cave. We're down pretty low. I believe we're on sort of Y12, in fact. So we're almost there. We're on our quest for diamonds here. As I said in the last episode, wanted to do a bit of mining and, you know, get those resources built up before we sort of found a place to settle down. And we're here now. So behind me, I actually went down there, or in fact through that gap right there, just where this what's that called, that granite, there's a bit of a cavern through here. And I actually poked my head through there last night in the episode that failed, and it was all a bit chaotic. There was loads of mobs down there, and I had to come back in here and hide away. So that's currently what I'm doing. I'm just cowering in my corner here, and we're actually going to head through there in a minute. But what I'd like to do before we do that is just head back up here. We've got a bit of lapis here, so I'm just going to grab that really quick. And quite a bit of lapis here. And what I want to do is just head back up here, because I did actually leave some materials up here, and in fact my inventory is completely full, so we may have to chuck a few bits here. So let's see what we've got up here. I did leave a furnace on the go, and there's a bit of iron in there, and there was a crafting table which I could do with, because I'm running low on planks here. So let's see if we can head back up, see if I can find my way back to the stuff, and we'll take it from there. So I'm just going to cut off here, and I'll be back in a mo. Okay then, guys, and we are back. So I've been back all the way up, and I've got back my furnace and my crafting table. I've got a few other bits and cleared out my inventory as well. So I've got a bit more room to gather a few more resources here, and what we're going to do is we're going to bust straight through here, and we're going to go take a look. So there was definitely a creeper and a skeleton here before, but they seem to have despawned now. So let's go straight through and see what we've got here. It's a very elaborate cave system here. Oh, that scared the life out of me. It's just a zombie. Oh crap, it's a creeper as well. Thank you, Mr. Creeper. That was fantastic. Oh no. Still not fully used. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Now this is getting crazy. We need to put some torches up there. Still not fully used to the new combat system yet, as you may have gathered. There's another two more creepers here. Whoa! Explosions everywhere. Oh my god! That was nearly the end of me then. Heal up, we're running low on food as well. Maybe I'm getting a bit too greedy here. Maybe I shouldn't be down here. Maybe this is a sign. Mind you, I haven't been down here for really that long. I definitely deserve some diamonds. What do you guys think? plenty of iron. Not seeing any diamonds though. Drop here. Let's take a look down the bottom. Nothing down here either. Plenty of mobs though. So many creepers! Oh my god. At least they're doing me favors. Bit of gold. As you can see, there's a few torches already down here as I came down here in the last episode. A bit more lapis. Awesome. Can hear a guy coming. Another creeper. I can hear a zombie villager again. Making my skin crawl, that sound. Come on, guy. I mean, very low on food here. Oh my, four creepers, are you kidding? Let's see if I can blow them all. This is not worth it. This is not worth it. I'm gonna try a different approach. I'm running very low on food here. This is a dangerous game I'm playing right here. Not doing too well here. I mean, this is the most open area that there is down here. And I'm not seeing any diamonds. Let's just dig in a bit. I think sometimes when you're looking for diamonds, you can look too hard and sometimes you just need to get digging. I believe they have a tendency to spawn quite close to other veins of ores as well, so if we mine away some of this coal, maybe we'll get lucky. While I'm just digging in here, I want to speak to you a bit more about the new features of 1.11. So you may remember in the last episode I went through a couple of the new features, but I kind of didn't really finish, you know, telling you about all the new features that are in there. And there's some really cool little bits that you know, if you don't know about already, you might want to know about. So there's a few different things that I didn't mention, and first of all, I've actually ruined my pick now and I've got no sticks at all, so I don't think I have any choice here but to go back up to the surface and just grab a bit more wood and then come back down. It might be wise for me to get a bit more food as well. So while I'm just heading back up here, We'll go through the new features, and there's a few different bits here. I actually made a few notes, and I'll share those with you now. So, again, this is all in the change log. I don't know if you've looked at that already, but it's a few different bits. So, you've got the cursed enchantments. I'm not sure if I mentioned that. So you've got the curse of binding and curse of vanishing. So the curse of binding basically means that once you put the, it can only be applied to armor items, and in fact I say applied, it can't actually be applied. You will find them only in sort of dungeons, and I believe they're very rare, to be honest. So, you know, I think it's more of a map maker's item to be used there, but I believe you can find them in dungeons. And what the curse of binding does is once you put the item of armor on that it is enchanted, you cannot then remove it. So say for instance they showed a diamond helmet in the video, once you put that on, then it's, you know, you're stuck with it forever. I'm not sure if it disappears or not if you die, but you know, interesting enchantment there. And then you've also got the curse of vanishing. So exactly as it sounds, once you have an item with the curse of vanishing, once you die, the item will vanish, and you will not be able to get that back. It will disappear. You will not be able to pick it up when you respawn, if you get back to your items. So another interesting one there, and again, I think that could be of more use to map makers. What else have we got? So we've also got we've got one new villager who has a couple of new maps for us to buy. And basically the two maps are the Ocean Explorer map and the Woodland Explorer map. And the Ocean Explorer map shows you on there where an ocean monument is in your world, and it will show you where you are in relation to that. And also it will basically, once you trade with the villager and you get the map, it will start as a blank map, and it will fill up as you move around the world and fill itself in, you know, like a regular map does. And you can find an ocean monument that way, which is pretty cool, I think. I don't know if there's any specific way in the game to find ocean monuments at the moment, so it's cool that they added that. And along with that, there's the Woodland Explorer map. Again, I'm not sure if I mentioned this in the last episode, but there's a brand new structure in the game called the Woodland Mansion, with a few new mobs in there and some unique drops as well. And the Woodland Explorer map will show you where the Woodland Mansion is. So you can find one of those. Apparently they're very, very rare spawns, so apparently the map is something that you are going to need to find one of those. So pretty exciting stuff, you know, especially the Woodland Mansion. We'll go into that in a second, but you know, pretty exciting stuff. And you know, hopefully we've got one of those ready to be found within this world, you know, right now. So we're playing that version with those features, so you know, hopefully we'll stumble across one. Okay, so what else have we got? There's a couple of small little features here in the end cities or the end islands. I'm not exactly sure the terminology. Basically they added in some, let's see, as you can see here, the coal is now working, and they basically added in some portals so that you can get back to the center of the end dimension once you're out on those islands. Like I said in the last episode, I've never been out to have a look at the islands and experience all that. That's all stuff that was added in my time away from the game. So, you know, I imagine once you're out in the end and you go into the end islands, you get very far away, and the only way to get back is to either kill yourself or to kind of build your way back to the center, which I imagine can take a lot of time. Or, you know, I mean, it's just not the most glamorous way of doing things. So I think they decided to add in the portal so you can get back and, you know, get back with a little bit more ease, I guess. So I think that's about everything that I didn't mention to you yesterday. except for the Woodland Mansion. So in there you've got three new mobs, and the three new unique mobs. There's the Vindicator, the Evoker, and the Vex. So the Vindicator is an axe wielding monster, and he's these are all classed as illagers, so they're kind of rejects from the villagers, I guess. And basically they've gone over to the dark side, and they're now fighting for the evils of Minecraft. And basically you've got this Vindicator, like I said, he wields an axe. They look a bit like a villager, but a lot paler. And I believe he actually drops emeralds, which I found out only yesterday, which is pretty cool. So once you kill those, you can get a few emeralds, which is nice, because they're extremely rare, and they're only in extreme hills, I believe. So yeah, pretty cool drop to get from them. And then you've got the Evoker, which, as the name suggests, it's kind of got ranged attacks, so it evokes different powers, and one of these is to evoke the Vex, which is a small flying ghost type thing, which, if you've not seen these, go check out some other videos. I'm sure we will get to it in this series, which should be pretty cool, and you'll see what I mean by this. And he's also got another ranged attack called Fang, I think it's called, and some crazy little sort of, I guess they look like bear traps, fly through the floor and they deal damage to you, which is pretty cool. And once you kill that guy, he actually drops a brand new drop called the Totem of Undying. And what this is you hold it in your, you can hold it in your offhand, or you can just hold it normally. And if you are dealt a death dealing blow by, any mob, or if you just fall to your death, if you're holding this in your hand, it will give you like a second wind, so you won't actually die. It will give you some extra hearts and some regeneration and some absorption for a very small amount of time, so that you then won't die, which is kind of cool. Again, it's hopefully something that we'll come across in this let's play, and I'm not sure how much I would use it myself, because I usually like to have the shield when playing this version of Minecraft, because the mobs are so much tougher now. As you could see in that cave there, I kind of had to run off a lot. If I had the shield, I might have been a little bit better off. Okay, so I think that's everything for the sort of the tangible new features of 1.11 that you will actually be able to play with. I mentioned llamas in the last episode. So pretty cool stuff, and I'm really looking forward to getting into it. And not just 1.11, the stuff that have been added in sort of 1.10, 1.9, and even 1.8, a lot of that stuff is still really new to me, so it's like almost playing a brand new game right now. So yeah, really looking forward to getting into this and seeing what we can uncover. So just cooking up a few little bits here. And while we're doing that, I've got some more planks out of this chest, so I'll make a new pick. And I think what we're going to do, instead of going back down into the mine, is we're going to have a bit of a wander around outside and just check out this area. I haven't really looked around much in the daytime yet. And what I want to do is just check out what's going on out there and see what we've got. See if we've got any llamas, potentially. Brand new mob added. I don't know how common they are, or whether they spawn in a specific biome or not, but I want to go up there and have a look around. I could do with finding some sheep as well, so I can find get some wool for a bed, and I will make some shears for that as well, so that we don't have to cut them down. We can just shave the wool off them and they will be happy as ever. So okay, let's see then. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to make a bit of a treacherous run outside here. I'm going to actually plant these seeds that I found in the dungeon and see what we've got. Okay. So we've got some melon seeds. We'll put the beetroot there and... Oh, he's ruined my crop. Stupid zombie. Okay, this isn't going particularly well. How far are we here? Ooh, an eclipse. Oh, is that an eclipse now? I don't know if that's actually called an eclipse in Minecraft or not. Full moon maybe. So we'll put the melon seeds down there. Okay. Deal with this guy. So what we're going to do now, I think I'm just going to pop down back into my hidey hole and I'm just going to wait out the night. So it should only be a few minutes, but I'm going to cut the video here and I'll be back in a moment. Okay guys, and we are back. So it's now daytime. We're going to pop out and have a bit of a wander around and see what we can find. And we'll deal with you first. I thought I heard him then with that last blow. I can hear a skelly as well. I'm just gonna leave that guy. So we've been sort of around that way and we sort of found those caves around there, but there wasn't really much else to find. So I think what we're gonna do is we're gonna head up over this hill and see what we can find over there. Okay, so I'm just gonna head up over there and while I'm doing that I'm gonna grab a bit of food from these piggies while we're at it. Thank you very much, Mr. Pig, it's all for a good cause. Thank you. Lovely stuff. Okay, so while we're sort of heading up, we're gonna head up to that hill and see what we got. Hopefully that'll give us a better view of the surrounding area and we can see if we've got any points of interest. So just while I'm heading up here, hopefully you guys will have noticed that this is now 60 frames per second. I spent quite a bit of time actually looking at the different recording settings. I'm still not sure it's perfect and I'm pretty sure I can do better for the hardware that I've got. But you should notice it's now nice 60 frames per second. I really love the smoothness that gives. And hopefully you guys will notice that. And the audio as well should be much better this time. I actually had myself mic'd up incorrectly last time. It's the first time using this mic and I didn't set it up correctly. I actually had it pointed slightly away from me, so it was picking up a lot of sort of background noise. You've probably heard my keyboard and along with that, you know, it just didn't sound great. It was kind of my voice echoing off the desk and it wasn't perfect, so should be much better this time round. And honestly, I'm not really seeing that much of any interest. The spawn was just sort of, I believe it was just over there in those trees. And it looks like that's just an ocean over to that direction. So I think we want to head over this way. And let's see what we can find. We've got a bit of wood. And what we want to do ideally is see if we can find some sheep as well. And if we do get far out, then obviously we can... If the night hits, we can sort of sleep in a bed and carry on going. So, should be all good there. So I'm not entirely sure if I really love this area. This biome as a, you know, as a place to sort of start the game properly. You know, I like to usually. Ooh, horses. Nice. Hello. Nice white horse, majestic. Gotta love those sounds. I don't think the white horses are particularly fast, though, in my experience. They don't have much health, at least. So we're gonna head over this way. There's a few sheep here, so that's awesome. I'll take your wool. Sorry about that. You might be a bit cold for a while, but it's much better than what it could have been. Lots of white wool. Lovely. Okay. So it looks like we've got a birch forest here. Nice variety of animals as well. I was just playing on another world actually earlier today, and there was just cows everywhere, so many cows, which is awesome because you can, you know, use the leather for books and things, but I'm just gonna stick a torch down actually, just so we know roughly where we're going here and where we've come from. But like I was saying, I was playing on a different world, on 1.10 world that I have, and I just couldn't find chickens anywhere. I wanted some feathers to make some arrows, and I just could not find chickens anywhere. It took forever. I ended up getting lost, and I ended up having to dive down in a cave and make a compass to find my way back. That's how lost I got, which was pretty incredible. But as I said, as I said previously, you know, I'm pretty notorious for getting myself lost in this game. So it looks like we've got another pretty big expanse of water over in that direction. And this, I wonder what's over there. That's pretty far. I think we should just carry on this way for the time being and just see where that takes us. Head through this forest. Hello, Mr. Cows. I'm not having too much luck here. Don't seem to have seen any llamas. Oops. Stick a torch here so we can kind of roughly see where we're going. I don't know about you guys though, but this is my favorite part of Minecraft, where you're kind of wandering into new territory. You've not explored the world at all yet. You don't know what's going to be there, and you know, you can see the new chunks being generated, and it's just this awesome. It's an awesome feeling to walk around and know that, you know, there could be anything around the corner. And I think this is something I was actually saying in the last video that I recorded and it failed, the audio. You know, that's one of my favorite things, you know, about Minecraft, and one of the things that really got me into it from the beginning. Just kind of the unpredictable nature of it, and you know, just everything being procedurally generated. It's such a cool concept. And I remember I started playing, the very first time I played on Minecraft was on the Xbox. And there is a little bit of a tutorial on there which kind of introduces you to a few of the concepts. But ooh. Hello, Mr. Wolf. Got no bones for you though. I have to come back here at some point and befriend him. But yeah, I started playing originally on the Xbox, and I was playing with my brother. You could play on split screen on the Xbox, which was absolutely awesome, being able to play split screen. And we had so much fun, you know. It was just kind of getting to learn the game and, you know, best practices and, you know, how to go about doing things and what to actually do. And it was, you know, it was so awesome just to sort of get into it. And that's, like I say, it's the thing that I love the most about this game. So we're getting pretty far away now, and I'm a bit conscious here that I don't want to lose my way. But let's see what direction we're heading in here, just to be safe. So we're heading in west, and we've only been heading literally in a straight line, so we should be okay as long as we go back east, and as long as I can remember that. So yeah, I mean, actually the sun's setting right over there, so visual indicator is always helpful. Let's get up on these trees and see what we can see. Some more hills over there. I think I'm gonna head over to those hills. I'm gonna cut it here. I'm gonna head over to those hills. I'll probably sleep through the night as well, and I'll be back in a moment. Okay, and we're back. So I've just headed over from, we were just over there, and we've just come through into these hills here, and still not really seeing anything, but let's just carry on here. Oh, guys, do you see what I see? It's a llama. Hello. Good day to you. Those sounds are priceless. Oh, they're awesome. Let's see if we can tame one of these guys then. Oh, maybe you have to do it with the empty hand. Oh, he's not my friend. I love how he's looking back at you when he's when you're riding him. Ah, there we go. So I'm pretty sure we can't ride these guys, but I remember you could put a carpet on them, so I've got some carpets here. And oh great. Look at that, that looks so great. That's so awesome. I love that, but we still can't ride them, so you must need a lead to do that, which we don't have currently. So we'll definitely have to find some slime balls. And in fact, I actually saw a swamp just over that way when we were on our way over, so I'm sure we can grab some of those and make a lead and bring all these guys back and get them all pimped out with all different colored carpets, and that'd be awesome. I just love this one. I love how when you put just a white carpet on it, it's got a few different colors to it, and it just looks so cool. That's awesome. Let's see if we've got any more llamas around here. See if we've got any babies. And it's getting dark already, so I'm just gonna quickly sleep here. Okay. So we've got a couple more over here, and I'm not seeing any others. So we've got that. That's a swamp right there. There's a swamp right there, and I believe that continues round. And these cliffs are absolutely epic along the coastline down here. That looks so good. Absolutely love that. So there we have it. Llamas, brand new to 1.11 in the wild on Survival Minecraft. Hello. And that's the first time I've seen them in Survival Minecraft. Don't know about you guys. That is That is absolutely awesome, and I love that. I love the carpet things. I really want to try some different colors and see what it looks like. That's awesome. So, on that note, I think we're gonna end it here. Thanks again for tuning in and for sticking with me. If you watched the first episode, if you didn't see it, check the playlist and you can check out the other episode. I'll put a link in the description. If you want to check out the snapshot, I'll put a link in the description to that one too. If you liked the video, please do leave me a like. That would be much appreciated. If you didn't like the video, give me a thumbs down. And if you really liked the video, feel free to subscribe. And once again, thank you so much for tuning in. I've been Lethal Bob, and I'll catch you again in the next episode. See you later.